Hello, friends. More often than not, money makes people greedy. It often leads them towards a negative path. Although having a lot of money is not such a bad thing, it becomes one when people are compelled to obtaining and amassing it. These desires, however, are not shared by all individuals. Today, I'll tell you a story about a woman who thought she had $1 billion in her bank account. She was surprised by what her bank account revealed. Stay until the end of the video to learn what happens when the woman finds $1 billion in her bank account. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon for more amazing stories like this one. Julia Yonkowski lived in Florida. She was in her late 70s and had a mediocre but happy life. Julia was married to a wonderful man who had recently passed away a few months ago. Julia and her husband had three children who were all settled in their lives. Julia lived alone now. Her children often visited her. Quite early in her life, she had learned the art of staying happy and content with little. One weekend, she went to her local Chase ATM in Largo to withdraw $20. When she put the card in to withdraw $20, the machine showed her that taking out $20 would cause an overdraft in her account and that she would be charged a fee. She decided instead to check her account balance. And according to the receipt, she had $999,985,855.94 in her account. Julia was shocked to discover a balance of almost $1 billion. It horrified Julia to see that. Most people would think that they won the lottery or something to justify that the money was theirs. But it was not the case with Julia. She was well aware of the situation. Julia had lived long enough to know that there was always some sort of mistake or misunderstanding. During her long and content life, she had read numerous stories about people who had taken the money and then had to repay it. Julia did not want to do that. She was aware that the money was not hers to take. It belonged to someone else. She was going to make sure that the rightful owner got their money back. More than that, Julia was worried that the money in her account could be a risk for her. She was scared because it could be a cyber threat. All of these thoughts were making her uncomfortable. She wanted to get rid of the money as soon as possible. She attempted all weekend to refund the money, but received no response from the bank. She tried to contact any official from the bank, but was unable to make contact. She could not get through. Every time she called, she got tied up with their automated system and could not get to a person. Julia then gave up and decided to visit her bank on a business day. Finally, on Tuesday, Julia visited the bank. She met with a manager of a Chase Bank branch. She informed him about the $1 billion she thought she had in her account. She told him that she wants it to be returned to its rightful owner as early as possible. The official appreciated her courage and honesty. Afterward, he cleared up the confusion with Julia. He disclosed to her that she did not temporarily have $1 billion. He informed her that her account balance was negative. He further told her that she had overdrafted. She owed some money to the bank. The official further told her that the number was an indicator of a fraud prevention method. This method is often used when the bank has to freeze an account. He informed her that it generally appears if an individual's bank account has been locked due to suspicious activity. This explained why Julia was unable to withdraw $20 from her account. The reason for the fraud prevention tactic was that Julia's late husband was a joint owner of the bank account, and when she attempted to use the card, the bank registered it as suspicious activity. The bank's representative explained that they required proper documentation to release the joint bank account to a sole individual. Julia's situation gained wide publicity on the internet and was soon the talk of the town. Local news outlets were all over this incident and wanted to know more about it. Thus, a spokesperson for Chase Bank had to clear things up. He informed the media that the customer did not temporarily have $1 billion, as had been widely reported. Rather, she temporarily owed it instead. Without disclosing too much of Julia's personal information, the Chase spokesperson said the incident was connected to the steps the bank takes when one person of a joint account dies. The measure is put in place to prevent fraudulent activity on an account. People asked him why the $1 billion figure was used in these situations. The spokesperson was unable to make a clear comment on that. However, he said that the matter had been completely resolved, and Julia was back to banking like a normal customer. She was neither a billionaire nor indebted for $1 billion. At the same time, another case was also making rounds. A negative $50 billion balance was showing up on multiple accounts belonging to several social media users. The spokesperson also cleared up that this was not connected to Julia's case in any way. He deemed it as merely a coincidence. He finished by saying that those incidents were caused by a technical glitch over the weekend and have also been fully resolved. The spokesperson also confirmed that despite their temporary 11-figure deficits, none of the people had been charged any fees. Julia was relieved to know that her money problem had been cleared up. She was glad she did not have to worry about it anymore. Julia also commented on the matter, saying that her incident could be an example for other people. She knew it had to be a misunderstanding, and she was right. Julia also gave the message to people of not letting money drive them. Julia insisted on trying to make money by all the right means. Keep working hard and be content with whatever God provides you. Our story ends here. Comment right below what you think about Julia and the way she handled the incident. Before going anywhere, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon to get amazing and inspiring stories like this one. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you next time.